Hi everyone, till now we have seen up to rectifier for regulated DC supply. So what is transformer, its function, then after that we have seen what is rectifier, basically full wave bridge rectifier, how it is working and what is importance, what is role, all these things we have seen. Next one we have to see filter. Filter is the second last section of regulated DC supply and the last section is regulator. So in this video we are going to see detail about filter. So actually filter, here basically we are going to see capacitor filter only. Capacitor filter, different types of filters are there: inductive filter, pi filter, capacitor filter, like the different filters are there. Here we are going to see capacitor filter only, and also we are going to just see the working only, not detailed analysis. Filtering, the word itself shows we are filtering out something, that is we are taking something and we are avoiding something. That is the meaning of filter, isn't it? We are filtering out something from a group of items, means we have to choose something from that item and we have to omit, avoid something from that item. So that is action filter. The circuit which do the same operation, it is known as filter. So you may study detail about this filter in higher semester. Here we are just explain what is filtering action. So you just understand only this much. Normally when we are saying pure AC or pure DC, the signal may not be like that pure AC or pure DC. It is a combination of these two signals. But we require pure DC at the output. So here we are using filter which pass DC only and blocks or filtering out AC signal. So one circuit like that is capacitor filter. So by theoretically you can understand like this: capacitor have the basic property of opposing the DC component and allows the AC component, or passing the AC component through it. So at the output of rectifier, it contains ripples, that is pulsating DC. Its meaning is unidirectional DC is there, but it's pulsating one. Along that one, some AC components are there. So those AC components will be bypassed by the capacitor, and it pass only the AC component. Means take here, this is the output of this bridge rectifier. So it is a pulsating DC, means DC plus some amount of AC is there. So that AC command will be bypassed by the capacitor and only DC will get at the output. That is the meaning of this filtering. Then how it is working here, that one we are going to see. So to understand that working, see, this is the output, this is actual input, AC input, and the negative half cycles are become as a positive half cycle at the output. Then this signal we have to rectify, sorry, we have to filter. So take this signal, this is the input signal, sorry, and this is the output of this one rectifier, and this is the first half cycle output of bridge rectifier, this one. Then this half cycle we are going to understand. When this signal is coming, the maximum value of this one is Vm, isn't it? So maximum value will be Vm. I am representing that like this, Vm. Then capacitor will be stored to this maximum value or this maximum voltage. Okay, so that one we can represent it here. See, capacitor is stored into the maximum voltage like this. Maximum value Vm, it reaches here. So capacitor stored is the maximum value of Vm up to here. And this plate of capacitor, you know, capacitor has polarity. So this plate of capacitor become positive because it is charged to this maximum value Vm. That positive polarity is here and corresponding negative value is here. So across capacitor we have a voltage Vm. Then this voltage want to discharge. This voltage want to discharge and the capacitor tries to discharge. It has only two paths. One is this way, second one is this way. Take this path, the left path. When it is reaches here at Q, it has two options. Either it has to discharge through D1 or it has to discharge through D3. That is like this or like this. But see, D1 and D3, N side is connected to the capacitor. And capacitor, the plate of the capacitor has positive value. The positive plate of the capacitor connected to the N side of D1 and D3. So that D1 and D3 will be reverse bias. If D1 and D3 has to forward bias, the polarity of D1 and D3 should be less than the value of voltage of the N side of D1 and D3 should be less than the P side, this point. This point means this point at point B and point A. But you know, the maximum value of supply voltage, it is Vm only. Here the supply voltage is Vm. The possible maximum value at transformer secondary, that is Vm only, that voltage reaches at point A and B. So the voltage at these two points, the P side of D1 and D3 is Vm only. And the same voltages reaches at the N side of D1 and D3, so that this one will become reverse bias. So it won't allow the capacitor to discharge at this time, at this point of time. So these two are open circuit. It is somewhat like this. Then what is the next possibility? The capacitor want to discharge through this path. If the value of resistance, this resistance, it is nothing but sometimes the resistance will be there, sometimes load will be there, whatever it is. So this resistance value is very high, so that capacitor is able to discharge very slowly. Slowly it will discharge. Slowly it will discharge. By that time, the voltage at this point is decreased. This voltage at this point is decreased by that time. So the voltage at this point will decrease less than Vm. Then next, negative half cycle is coming. That time it's again become forward. It is passed only in one direction, unidirectional. So the negative half cycle become in positive half cycle at this. Then you can see the capacitor is slowly discharged from this point to this, slowly discharged. So it is reaches here. By that time, the second negative half cycle, its value is increased and it reaches here. Then see, when it is reaches here, the value of capacitor is slightly less than, say, 1 millivolt or 1 volt. If Vm is 10 volt, now capacitor value is only a 9 volt because the 1 volt is discharged through this part. If Vm is 10 volt, 1 volt of capacitor discharged through R. By that time, the second half cycle came here. When the voltage of A and B, it is greater than 9 volt. 9 volt. I am taking example Vm as 10. That is the reason I am taking here 9. Greater than 9, these two paths become forward bias, diode become forward bias because here only 9 volt, but if it is 9.5, I am saying sorry, have say Vm is 10 volt, Vm is 10 volt, Vm is 10 volt. After this discharging, from 10 volt to it is reaches to 8 volt. Say it is 8 volt. It reaches here, it is 8 volt. By that time, the negative half cycle reaches its maximum value. So, the negative half cycle becomes as a positive half cycle at output side. Then, when this cycle's value is greater than 8 volt, 8 volt at this point, it is greater than 8 volt or 8.6 volt, this path becomes forward bias. Again, this path becomes forward bias. Any one of this path, any one of this path. Then the capacitor again will charge through this path. Capacitor will charge through this path up to which value? Maximum value Vm, that is 10 volt. Then capacitor again reverse bias this D1 and D3. Again reverse bias D1 and D3. Then D1 and D3 will be open circuit. Then capacitor has only one option, it has to discharge through R. Like that, capacitor is convert this much fluctuating unidirectional signal, this time fluctuating DC value to somewhat constant value like this. This is theoretically, we say it is bypassing the AC component and passing DC component. So, at the output, we are getting a signal somewhat like this. This one fluctuation is less. Okay, this is the working of capacitor filter. Then, see, not only capacitor filter, you can say inductive filters are there, then inductor filter. Here, how theoretically we can say inductor filter, it is blocking AC component. So, we are getting DC only at output. But again, there is some inductor will not block entire AC. So, some DC will be here. That DC will be bypassed by this capacitor. This inductor capacitor filter, you can study by yourself. It is not in the part of syllabus, but for the reference, you can choose. In the syllabus, only this capacitor filter is there. Then pi filter is there because the capacitor may not be, single capacitor may not be omit the maximum AC component. So, first capacitor bypass some of the AC component. Second capacitor again bypass remaining AC component. Even though we are bypassing all these AC components, there will be small ripples at outside. That one we can remove by using voltage regulator. That one we can see in the next slide. In the next class. Thank you.